Hey everyone, it's Harmony. I am here today to show you how to grow and harvest runner beans. So this here is my runner bean pole, and I have a few different kinds of runner beans on this pole, on this trellis here. The trellis is made out of bamboo, and it's triangled into two sides, and then they're connected up at the top, and there's a few running lines going this way to hold the lemon cucumbers also. So I have lemon cucumbers on here. I have scarlet runner beans. We also have some of these beautiful purple pole beans and some pellegrino pole beans. One of my favorite beans of all times is these amazing heirloom scarlet runner beans. They have a most beautiful red, amazing, fiery flower, and you can kind of see them up at the top. The hummingbirds love them, the butterflies love them, and they're also edible. Almost every part of this plant is edible, the scarlet runner bean, and when they're about this small, nice and thin, is when I love to just eat them raw. Really, really good like this. And when they get a little bit bigger, they'll get about this big. And as you can see in the light, you can see there's little beans inside of there. And they'll start to grow quite a bit bigger, and they'll get about a foot in length. And all of the beans inside will grow to about the size of kidney beans. And these beans are so beautiful inside, but they do contain lectin, and this lectin is kind of toxic when you don't cook it out. So when the bean gets bigger than this and you pull it open and eat the big beans, because it'll get tough when it gets bigger than this, and you can pull it open and eat the bigger beans, but you need to cook those off first a little bit before you throw them in a salad or a soup or whatever. They are extremely delicious though, really sweet, kind of like sugar snap peas when they're this small. And then when they get bigger, you can use those seeds, all or the beans also, for seeds for the next year. And it's really important, I always make sure I let a few of these beans go to seed so that I can collect them and keep them heirloom for generations to come. So how I like to harvest these beans is often with one hand I will take it and I'll support my finger, and I'll just kind of pop it off like that. And I like to gather those in my basket. I'll put all these in the basket here. And also, if you like, you can come along and clip them off, and you can clip them right above where it joins the stem. Or you can also use two hands, and this is what I encourage for my kids, because they love to come out here and eat all the time during the day and just graze, and I really love that they love to do that, but I want to make sure that we protect the plant. So I tell them to come and grab it just above where it joins the stem, and I'll just pull. So using two hands, I'll hold one part at the plant and one part at the bean, and it seems to come off really nice that way, and you don't damage the plant or pull it down off the vine or break it. So I'm going to harvest these, and I really like to harvest them when they're like this. My favorite, and I'm gonna have some delicious green beans tonight for dinner. Another thing that I want to make sure that I do is maintenance the older growth. And when you don't maintenance the older growth, you'll see that it will maintenance itself. It'll start to turn yellow, and then it will start to turn brown, and it will actually start to mold. So this is important to get this out of your growth, and it also clears more light to come through to the fresher leaves, and it will also kind of clear any air to come through and make sure you don't get any diseases and mildews and things. So once again, these are amazing heirloom scarlet runners. And there's some other really nice beans in here, and some lemon cucumbers as well. I've grown all of this in what really is only about 5 square feet of space, of ground, and then the 7+ feet upwards that I made the trellis into. And you can germinate these inside, or you can also just plant them right into the ground in the early or in the late spring. I planted these in about May, and I'm here in the Pacific Northwest in Washington State. And as you can see, they're incredibly prolific. I'm just going to do a little bit of pruning, clean it up a bit.